I'm Ashin Antony. This is a wireless power transfer circuit. Nowadays, everyone is having a great use of mobile phone, a lot of electronic devices like mobile phones, watches, power bands, many devices, which require to be charged through some USB cable from a power supply, So this is a mechanism through which power can be transferred to it through wireless means. That is using the principle of induction. Now many electronic devices, many such technologies are available in the market. This is just a demonstration of one such technology. What it uses is not much bigger things. Like these are some two basic electromagnetic principles which we study in high school physics. One is Faraday's law and the other is Ampere's law and the other is Faraday's law. Ampere's law states that when there is a current flowing through a circuit and a magnetic field is created across it, and Faraday's law states that when there is a changing magnetic field through a coil, an EMF is induced in the nearby coil through the principle of mutual induction. These two are the basic principle which is used in the circuit. So now just the demo is shown here. So now this demo is shown using LEDs and all. So this can be used for any power source and any other electronic device. So here we can see like when power is getting transferred from this coil to this coil through mutual induction. That is when there is a current flowing through this coil, an EMF is induced in this coil, and this is causing the LED to get turning on. So any electronic device can be connected as a load here, and any power source can be kept here. So now I will just show the circuit diagram. So basically what it is having is one battery, one switching device which is a transistor, and a primary coil and a secondary coil and the load. So the basic working of the circuit is like this. When the circuit is getting turned on, when the battery is just turned on, at that instance there is no current flowing through this path, so the transistor is off. So initially initially current flow through this 1 ohm path only, and at that time the transistor is off, and when there is sufficient current for the transistor to turn on, the transistor turns on, and then the when the turning on time, the inductor will act as a short circuit. When there is sufficient turn on time, the inductor will act as a short circuit, and the high current will flow through the inductor. And when the inductor is short, almost all the current which is drawn from the battery will be flowing through the inductor, and as a result, the current flowing through this 1 kilo ohm resistor will be zero, and this causes transistor to turn off. So what is this like this? At some instance transistor is on, and at other some instance the transistor is off. So it is like switching on and switching off, and this causes somewhat like alternating current flowing through that coil, and this causes changing magnetic field, and this induces a changing EMF in the nearby circuit, which causes the other power transfer. Thank you.
So I am Gokulan from DSC department. I am first year M.Tech. So the another project we are having here is current short circuit protection. Okay. So basically, any electronics or electrical devices will be having some kind of short circuit protection circuit inside it. So this one is the basic circuit. Okay. So every circuit will be having some kind of power supply here and some load here, and when you are connecting your when you are shorting your output terminals, it will draw a very large current from the battery that will in fact can burn your circuit itself. So that is to be prevented. So this is one kind of circuit we have here. So this is the battery or power supply for this circuit, and these are the output terminals. Okay, so you can see like now it is working under normal condition, and the outputs are not shorted. So when you short these two terminals, you can see the red LEDs glowing. So that means okay. So now I am going to short it, you can see the red LEDs glowing, like it shows that the output is under short circuited. Okay, so that's what's happening here. So basically, inside the circuit, we have a op amp and a switch like a MOSFET or BJT. So here we use the MOSFET. Okay, so MOSFET gate is driven by the op amp output, and op amp is made under open loop condition. So open loop means there will be no kind of feedback things. So only the differential input is getting amplified by the op amp towards the output. Okay, so that output is fed to the MOSFET. So when you are shorting, you are actually making the differential input as zero. That means there will be zero output at the op amp output pin. That means the MOSFET will be, or MOSFET or whatever switch you are using, will be turned off. Like, so by that principle, you are switching from normal mode of circuit operation to the short circuit mode of operation. So that's how the basic circuit works. So these kind of things you can see any kind of electronic or electrical device. Okay.